Sebastian and an inconvenient anime here tonight. Everybody, this is Million Dollar Extreme.
Hey, everybody, my name is Charles Carroll, also known as Richard Windsor, look him up. It's great to be back here. It's been a long time. I feel really safe. It's been a minute since I've been to New York. It's fucking cool, but that's not what I came here to talk about, okay? I want to talk about something else. I want to talk about video games. I know you all like them. Some people might think they're kind of gay. I don't know. Do they think they're kind of gay? You might think they're full-blown gay. I don't know. Would you think it was gay if a full-blown gay man came in here and mowed everyone down? Mowed everyone down after his playing video games for a few years? You know, start getting real crazy. I've been playing video games my whole life. Mostly killing games, and I started with Mario Brothers. Now, the Japanese were really good at making some real crazy things. Games where you could be, killed by a mushroom, you know? It's a sort of a sick thing. Must be a cultural. It's a cultural thing, I think. It's a cultural sickness. Getting used to playing someone's mind, you can start the homegrown game developers, or the homegrown terrorist game developers, like id Software, right at the turn of the 90s when it came around, okay? Wolfenstein, you know the classics. Doom, you know Doom. It's a classic training game. You know, people have used that. It's some pretty rough stuff. I don't know. Let's not talk about Doom, though. You know, it's been kind of done up a little bit. I don't want to talk about Quake. Who likes Quake?
Yeah. Okay,
Quake 1's great. You know, I love John Carmack. I love John Romero. I love the whole id Software team. They're very dear to me. There's certain things that require timing, okay? Sometimes it's just... Quake 3, you know, I know you guys are familiar with Quake 3 and Quake Live, you know, you can play it on your browser, you know, do it, Netscape, play it on Netscape, do it everyone. The level of the mind, not a game anymore, then you graduate. It's dehumanized, so it's a friendly environment, you know, you don't have to shoot people, you can shoot aliens or, you know, just things, big dicks, whatever they have, do whatever you want. Let me put it this way, if you can navigate through a map, jumping backwards, you know, with your eyes closed, and you can still end up where you want to go, and you know it 100%, then you own it. You know, you own that area. And... They don't fly around. Like a quake. It sounded like the ceiling was ripping. They don't fly around a quake. You better walk around. You don't want that. You know, just break the barrier, you know, start getting people at each other's heads. I could say that getting a gun right now would be a problem, but I would be lying if I were to say that, because many people I know have you ever seen the modded the AK-47s into a pistol, you know, the one that anyone ever see the video of that thing shooting up? You know, I know a few people, at least one person that has that. So, you know, guns, it's just not a problem, it's just not. I wasn't involved in any MK Ultra, you know, I wasn't initiated, I was not a graduate of MKU, you know, so I'm not on psych meds. I'm not taking any psych meds. And let's say if there are five people coming right here with machine guns, okay? You know? If they walked right in here, it would be just as easy as, you know, just getting down, stabilizing yourself. I had my line of sight right here, I had a little bit of cover. Right when they walk in, I have it together, you know, I see people coming in, I can just sit down and stabilize myself and... One, two!
That was the worst thing ever.
I don't think there's any way I could possibly come back from that. There's no way I could.
Come on, man.
There's no way I could come back.
You got it.
I thought I was going to go online, I had my own mind blown right now.